We're heading to the first session of the Habitation Conference.
Are you ready? He makes a way where there ain't no way.
Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner. Babe, how hot is it here?
It's like I'm inside of a dryer.
Is it worse in Florida?
It's so much worse.
So there train he is. Her to use the camera, bro.
You excited about tonight, Tanner?
So excited.
What are you excited about?
I'm excited for the Lord. He's going to show up. And then Corey's going to be here, too.
And then Corey will be here.
Yeah.
What's up, dude?
That's right.
What's going on,
what's up,
man?
Bro? You doing well?
I am.
You ready to preach tonight?
I think so.
What you going to talk about?
I'm going to tell mama jokes for about 20 minutes.
It's a good opener.
I don't know, man. We're going in.
You have like a theme.
Yeah. I feel in Isaiah 66, two dwelling places of God, the throne room and the broken and contrite heart.
Gosh.
So.
Tell me what you said. You said to me, tonight I'm coming in weak. How did you say
it? Yeah, I'm coming in weak. It was a hard day. It was a good day. My prophetic side at 7:22:22. Hey. It was a good day, closed on a house and bought a house in Denver, a lot of swirl, but also feeling a lot of anxiety and fear and swirl. So constantly in wrestle mode all day, just in my soul. So I usually, these kinds of moments, I'm just coming in weak and leaning and, trusting that the Lord's going to flex in it. So, that's it.
That's
powerful. He's going
to
flex in it.
He's going to flex.
I'm just going to come weak and leaning too. We're just going to
show off.
So you're excited though about Habitation in school.
Yeah, bro, I've been crying all day.
Really?
Bro, we just had pre-service prayer.
Yeah.
And I read Jeremiah 33 when he says, if you can break my covenant with the day and night, then you can break my covenant with David. And just that overwhelming of like thousands and thousands of years later, remember David.
Oh my God.
Gosh, dude. So we just have been crying and just don't want to get caught up in being enamored by the event.
Yeah, gotcha.
I want people to be lost in him, you know.
Tell me about the school. Like, are you excited about the school?
Yeah, honestly, I'm a little nervous to announce it. I don't know why. Yeah. But it's such a big, big move for us. But School of Habitation, it's honestly what Emily and I dreamed of, and now with you guys jumping in, I just see a community being built around the presence of God that are going to be students of his continual coming. So I have so much anticipation in my heart for it. It's kind of hard that we have to wait till January for it to launch.
Yeah.
But I think the anticipation's building and I want to see a generation come in, man.
If there's a generation starving for fathers and discipleship and for a true North Star, not a stage, not look at me, look what you can get to, but absolutely undoing a generation with the revelation of him and leading the way in that. And I think that's what this school is all about, is pointing a true North Star that will keep these kids hungry for decades and keep them, you know, navigating through all of life's storms, victories, valleys, all of it. And I'm just happy to be a part of serving this generation for that end.
Awesome, man. You guys both have such cool voices.
The Lord is in.
A river of longing is here. Pour out upon me a river of longing. Pour out upon me a river of longing. Lift your hands. He wants to release a river of longing. My soul longs, yes, even faints for the courts. Release the river of longing upon your people.
Hey. So we just finished with the first night of habitation. Corey Russell preached. My favorite thing that he was talking about tonight is that God looks down into the earth, and what he's looking for is that one who has a limp, that one who is broken and contrite and lowly. Oh, it moved my heart tonight. Lord, make me broken, contrite, lowly, and dependent.
Satisfaction is not a side issue.
Yeah.
Satisfaction is the very means by which God frees you and enables you to be able to obey him. Your slavery was that you are unsatisfied. Now you've been satisfied by Christ, and it sets you free from that plague of unsatisfaction that looks for all kinds of things.
Wow. Let's talk about you for a second. Let me just say, Eric comes up in this place and starts dropping bombs on us. And it was like, I've just never heard you like that before. But man, I haven't felt a sweetness like I felt today in a long time. And from worship to when you got up, I just am so thankful for you, bro. He's teaching a generation what it means to come into the chamber of the Lord and enjoy it.
Tell them about the school when it starts.
School of Habitation. School of Habitation begins January 2023. This was something that the Lord put in my heart at the last Habitation in January. And I kept hearing this phrase, School of Habitation, students of his presence, students of his coming, the continual coming of Christ, that great day that we are all expecting, but yet also every time he walks into a room, knowing how to steward his presence. And so we just announced that we are launching a school in January 2023. You can register at schoolofhabitation.org. Someone just flushed the toilet. And here's the most exciting thing is that Eric and I and Corey Russell are teaming up because we believe that the Lord is inviting a generation to go beyond the veil and to make their home there. And so we want to invite you to come. We're so excited. It's going to be amazing. And I just have this dream of a community that walks into rooms with bowls of oil ready to pour it on his feet.
Where can they find you first?
So all the information is on schoolofhabitation.org. Right, Jenny? Schoolofhabitation.org? That's it. Schoolofhabitation.org. This is our director.
Hey.
The school right there. S-O-H.
Yep.
She is.
Schoolofhabitation.org.
Yes.
See you there.
Everything's there. And there's videos and all kinds of stuff. And we're excited to have you guys apart. Come check it out.
William and I are about to do a podcast together. We have no idea the subject.
We'll figure it out.
We'll figure it out. Probably going to be Christ or something like that.
Something about Jesus, believe it or not. Hey, everyone. Welcome to the Habitation Podcast. I'm here with one of my best friends in the world, Eric Gilmore. He just finished session number 2 at Habitation here in Dallas, and honestly, I don't have words for what we just experienced.
So I just finished ministering here at Habitation. I spoke on Jesus, altogether lovely. Everything about him excites love for him in our hearts. That love is wanting to obey him and put his desires above ours, wanting to spend time with him, wanting to tell others about him. Wanting to just enjoy him above all other things. Well, really, enjoying him above all other things. So it was a wonderful time. Habitation worship today was just glorious.